is a fact, right? It's indisputable and unrefutable. Now, I want women that claim to be believers in the Most High to really listen to me today, right? This KT Morning Show is about men was created to rule. See, a woman of the Most High is going to say, yeah, well, I love that. I love that male strength, that male power. You dig what I'm saying? But a feminist? And you got to understand that a wicked patriarchal system set up feminism. Men like Erich Fromm, Karl Marx, destruction of family, all of that is feminism. Well, so men are going to always rule. I want women to get this. I mean, this is not designed to offend anyone, because a man doesn't have a voice. That's what the Most High sent me, a spokesman for men, right? And I'm not really that sharp and intelligent of a guy. You see what I'm saying? I just do things in repetition until I get it. I'm not a smart dude like the Bean. I think the Bean skipped through school and all of that. He was so smart. I mean, what y'all don't know is the Beam is a really intelligent dude, man. He picks up on things real quick. Me? I ain't gonna hold you, man. I gotta do it again and again and again to get it. That's just the way I'm designed, man. It takes me a while to figure things out. But it's my consistency. It's my indomitable spirit that pulls me through. It makes me dissident. You understand what I'm saying? Because, listen, man, I'll bleed for this, and I'll perish for this. That's what makes me dissident. And everything that I bring forth is didactic. Whether you like it, understand it, believe it or not, if you receive it, it's going to change your life. Yeah, I wasn't the sharpest tool in the shed. But yo, man. You don't have to be the sharpest tool in the shed when you got a stone that you can sharpen it with. You dig what I'm saying? Most wealthy people got around people that was smarter than them. You dig what I'm saying? Did Steve Jobs finish college? Nah. College, those that go to college and finish is for bozos. Because most of y'all are working for someone else. People around me with the degrees I do way better than them. Much more successful than them. But I'm still building, man. I'm still that lion going up with an insatiable desire to be the best that I can be. Why? Because the Most High made me as a ruler. I man. I want to clear something up. Because some of you, you know, when you read these new international versions of the Bible and so on and so forth, it's trying to make you believe, for example, the new international version of the Bible, it says to the woman, he said, I will make you, so on and so forth. Right? But when you go back and read Genesis 1 and 26, see, that's what I want to deal with. Bereshit 1 and 26 real quick. Because these new international versions of the Bible and so on and so forth, they were trying to make you to believe that is talking about mankind. They put the word mankind there. But if you read, see, it says in the new international version that then Yahuwah said, let us make mankind in our image. That's a damn lie. See, this is why you got to understand the Hebrew, right? And the New Living Translation, it says, Yahuwah, they put the word God there, right? Let us make man, let us make human beings. That's a lie, too. The word doesn't translate to that. You can't put what you want to put there. The word there in the Hebrew, when you look at that in the Hebrew, the word is Adam. Adam. It's not no mankind. It's not no humans. They're trying to put that there to throw you off. They're trying to take away the gender. See, the Hebrew is gender specific. Understand that. Understand that. So it's gender specific. It says, let us make man Adam. When you look, you go and look it up in the word, you can go and look up in Strong's. Adam is masculine singular. It has nothing to do with femininity. Don't try to put all humans in there. The Most High deals with specifics. It's showing you that man was created to have dominion over everything. And how was man created? In our image, after our likeness. Understand that. So I want to make that abundantly clear that the Most High designed man and gave him dominion to rule over his family. You understand that? To rule over his family. That's the first unit. Family is the first organizational unit in the world. So this is where Paul came and said, how can a man rule the church if he can't rule his own family, right? Because all rulership starts with the family. There's no equality, man. Well, see, when you deal with worldly Negroes, when you deal with wicked patriarchy, a wicked patriarchal system, they're trying to make you think things are supposed to be equal. That's not what the Most High says. That is ungodly. That is anti-Christ. That is against the words of the Most High. Understand that. Understand that. Now, you can like and understand it, believe it or not, but you bucking up against the truth is not going to change the truth. The truth is going to always be the truth and doesn't owe anyone an apology. Just because we have wicked patriarchal men ruling today and pushing feminism doesn't mean it's supposed to be that way. You cannot change the natural order of things the way that the Most High designed it. He makes that very clear. Again, in Bereshit, Genesis 3 and 16, he says, your desire shall be unto your husband, and he shall rule over you. Everybody understand that? So that means any woman that's in the spirit, in the true spirit of the Most High, is going to want her man rule over her. Otherwise, you're not a woman of the Most High. So you start to create excuses, but none of that could be read anywhere in the Bible. Your excuses. Well, he's this. It doesn't say if he's this, he's that. It says he's supposed to rule over you. He's like God unto you. You understand that? When you read the book of Ephesians 5 and 22, it says, wives, obey your husbands like Adonai. You use the word Lord there. Say a husband's like God unto you. He was created to rule. And men need to get back under that paradigm. And I'm a spokesman for men. I'm going to teach hard. They don't want platforms where men could speak freely. They don't want platforms where men are encouraging other men. But I'm going to do it. You can't stop this truth. It's the truth. I shouldn't have to apologize for the truth. And I won't. And I don't. Understand that. Understand that. Genesis 3 and 16. He's unto the ish. Unto high ish. High isha. High isha. Well, unto high isha. The word high is like the. In the Ibrit, the transliteration in English would be the word the or the. Unto high isha. Isha is the woman. The ish is the man. So it's gender specific. So we can see that the Ibrit deals with gender specific. This is making a distinction between male and female. Well, Haisha. It's a noun. It's a feminine singular. You can look it up in Strong's 802 yourself. That's talking about a woman. It could mean a woman, a wife, or a female. So he's dealing with specifics. He said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrows and thy conception. In sorrow, thou shalt bring forth children, and thou desire shall be unto your husband. Huh? Thy husband. The last part is, and he shall rule over thee. He shall rule over thee. See, the Most High created man to rule. Society's trying to change that. We can't let them change that as men. You got to stand up and be men. Shout out to Daenerys, man. Shout out to Daenerys, man. Yahuwah created men to rule their homes, to rule the church, and to rule the world. Men will always rule. Yeah, women talk about we coming up. Listen, man, the real truth is because a man allowed that. You understand that? I know I seem a little harsh right now, but I need to be frank with some women.